Mr. Internet.
More and more, the line between the virtual world and the real world is getting blurred, and nowhere does this happen more than in the world of Warcraft. Case in point, 17-year-old kid in Beijing douses another kid with gasoline and lights him on fire. His defense? Been playing a lot of World of Warcraft, thought I was a fire mage. That's an example of jumping from virtual to real life. There are also examples of real life jumping over into the game. Recently, a 52-year-old woman who was a World of Warcraft participant and enthusiast died in real life, and members of her guild held her funeral in the game at her favorite spot, a place called Winter Spring, which is a body of water adjacent to a lovely meadow. Well, they gathered there to hold this funeral in the game, and when they did, another group, a splinter group, a controversial group, descended upon that funeral and killed everyone present. I ain't no goddamn son of a bitch. You better think about it, baby. I ain't no goddamn son of a bitch. You better think about it, baby, baby. With me now is Matt Kement, the leader of that controversial faction which staged the raid. Now, Matt, am I saying your name right?
Yep.
Okay, because I want to get that right, because I feel like there's some chance that you could kill me, and since I don't have a game character, the only avenue for you to do that would actually be a real life, so I don't want you to like show up at my loft with a battle axe or something. You are the leader, in essence, of Serenity Now, which is, explain to people what that is.
Yeah, it's a guild in World of Warcraft. We're kind of a normal bunch, a little bit of a rowdy bunch, but
I would say rowdy about covers storming a funeral and dispatching everyone there.
Yeah.
Why?
Attention. We just kind of capitalized on the 15 minutes of fame that would have come with it. What I always tell everyone is, if we didn't do it, someone else would have.
I've used that. I mean, I've done, you know, like if I cheat on a significant other, I'm always like, well, if it wasn't me, somebody else is going to do it. How many hours a week would you say that you play, you know, on a typical week?
Maybe 15 or so. I mean, there are people who put in more than 40 hours. I mean, the game's easily a full-time job for them. The way the game works is if you're on a PvP server, player versus player, which we are, there are zones that are called contested zones. And when you're in those contested zones, you can attack other players at will.
They erroneously held the service. I understand it was at a location called Winter Spring, which is some body of water that's adjacent to a serene meadow. But this is a contested zone, you're saying?
It is.
Did you cover escape routes? I mean, or is this just straight up shock and awe?
Shock and awe.
Well, the dress code, if you will, of a typical funeral played into your favor because you guys were kitted out with armor and they were wearing like suits and whatever.
Yeah. You know, one person in gear can take out five people that aren't in gear without any trouble at all. So.
And like a virtual linen smock is not going to do anything against like a fireball or
anything at all. No.
What was the reaction to this thing?
What would I say? Probably about 75% bad, 25% good. shortly after this whole thing went down, our site got hacked. People were just going nuts on the forums. People were going nuts in game. We've had people come on the forums claiming to be the girl who died's brother, saying, I'm going to sue you all.
Would he sue you in the game? Is there a barrister character? Or would you?
No, I think he meant actually sue us.
You've captured the game footage, and you've edited this piece. I know it wasn't probably the motivation behind doing it, but in the end, you're left with a pretty amazing little piece of content there.
We first put it up on Google Video. I think it had like 2 or 2.5 million views there. Then he added the title on it to a bunch of sexually explicit stuff just to get more search results. And
nice.
Google didn't like that, and they took the video down. Put it back up on YouTube. I think it's at something like 3.2 million views on there now.
Did you guys ever try to edit this to Celine Dion? Did that work? Did you try different tracks up against it?
There is another version of the video. I don't think it has Celine Dion in it.
Well, that, folks, is Matt Kement. Matt, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for
having
me.
Very enlightening. And listen, we'd like to stay in touch with Serenity Now. We know you have covert operations that you'll never talk to us about, but anything above board you want to discuss, we're all ears.
All right.
He's going to kill me. There was a couple times when he was irritated, and I know he's going to try to get me. But I think I could take him. Did you see him? You shouldn't be afraid of a paladin in the game, because when they come out and they come to your door and they're like, nothing comes out.
But if it's a warrior from the game, you can go down to any novelty store, one of those cutlery places at the mall, and buy like a 4-foot-long sword. So I'd be more afraid of him if he was a warrior. But he's a paladin, so I think I'm good to go.
I think if I was a World of Warcraft character, I would probably be like a reptile called Magikzilla. And I would have scales and stuff, but then magic that came out of my hands and tail. And like these would be like claws here, but then the stuff, magic would come out. I'll kind of be like, you know, somebody be like, "What? You're coming? You want to go?" You know, and I would push it. Like the magic would come together here, and then I would push it out.